I'm the author of the book. Yeah, genius wrote it. There's a message in my words, you gotta decode it. I seen it all, every gram, every bird. I spit the truth, every noun, every verse. I never exaggerated one line, one dime. Never lied to the people, not one time.
Never.
A hard head make a soft ass. And hard white'll get you straight cash.
It'll hurt your eyes. I really live it, man. Got so much paper, it'll hurt your hands.
Cockroaches everywhere, hit the kitchen lights, now it's marble floors everywhere. Call the carpenter, the roof on the coop's gone. Give a fuck what he sold, I'm the truth, homes. Kitchen fumed up, niggas jamming Tupac. Get my Benny Hunters on, working two pots. Baby need shoes, partner need bail money. Bloodhound for the bread, I just smell money. Niggas just right, I recollect. Hands on Jesus, really counted them checks. I'm Donald Trump in a white tee and white ones. The conversation is money, nigga, you want some?
It'll hurt your eyes. I really live it, man. Got so much paper, it'll hurt your hands.
I'm what the streets made me, a product of my environment. Took what the streets gave me, product of my environment. Now it's 28 inches on a brand new Hummer. Tell me right now it's gonna be a cold summer. Blew the brains out the Chevy, call it suicide. It's a way of life, that's how young niggas ride. Trap or die, gave them hope. They waiting on the sequel. It's good to see the boy Jesus do it for the people.
There's
a message in my words, you gotta decode it. I seen it all, every gram, every bird. I spit the truth, every noun, every verse. I never exaggerated one line, one dime. Never lied to the people, not one time.
Never.
A hard head make a soft ass. And hard white'll get you straight cash.
Hey.
used to hit the kitchen lights. Cockroaches everywhere. Hit the kitchen lights. Now it's marble floors everywhere.
Hello, my friends. Hello, my friends.
Happy Friday.
Give a fuck what he sold.
Another Friday. Yeah, I think I did. Yeah, I did. What a leap years. Leap goes ever on Friday?
I don't think it matters. But, yeah, I think it's 52 Fridays in a year. Pretty sure.
In 52 weeks, so that makes sense. I guess it technically could not be 52 Friday. We're not guaranteed 52, right?
Are you counting them, though? Are you really keeping track of Fridays?
I'm saying the weeks. Like, right. Maybe a week, maybe the year starts on, like, a Tuesday, and that fucks up the math.
Yeah.
I cussed already. I'm sorry, Gabe. This doesn't count. We're not showing the pictures yet. I'm sorry.
Cool.
Hey, my friends. Hey, my
What's
friends.
Up? Happy Friday, y'all.
Hey, my friends. We are live.
We live, baby.
Season 2. Episode 2, right? Of the Pop-Up TV.
Yeah, we in here.
I am one of your hosts, Danny.
What's up, Danny? I'm Kevin Woods. Nice to meet you. The Pop-Up owner here, co-host with Danny on the Pop-Up TV. And we got our very humble technician behind the scenes running all this crazy chaotic stuff. I wish I could see all these cores. Gabe.
It's crazy.
What's up, Gabe?
How's it going, everybody?
How you doing today, man?
I'm good, man. Breathing.
Breathing?
You know what I'm saying?
With a mask on, though.
I'm with the mask on.
Okay.
The man, the myth, the legend, yeah. Gabe. Shout out to Gabe. Shout out to Gabe, the Pop-Up. Shout out to the Hawks. And shout out to everybody that's listening and watching. Yes, only watching. Mm-hmm. We are here in this beautiful space in Chicago.
Yeah.
West Loop. What's the address here?
208 North Green Street, Chicago, Illinois, 60607.
Pull up, man. It's very close to the Morgan stop here in Chicago, but also online at
thepopup.com/shop.
Shop till you drop. A lot of cool shit here in the shop. But yeah, we are the Pop-Up TV, the best place for jokes, to buy dope shit, just talk about the news, man.
Yeah. What are you wearing today, man?
What am I wearing?
You got a vintage, like, Olympic jacket on.
Yeah, y'all didn't ask me about it. I've been in this fucking shop for the past hour and a half, and no one asked me about it. I'm furious.
Honestly, it's the first thing I saw when you walked in. It looks great. Can everybody, like, on the chat, like, give Danny props on his Olympic jacket? 1992?
You know,
or was that 96 on Michael Johnson?
I don't know what year it is.
That's 1996 replica Nike jacket from when Michael Johnson was on the track team.
So, I got this at a Goodwill.
Okay.
In Burlington, North Carolina.
Okay.
Needless to say, I probably got this 8-9 years ago. So needless to say, in a random Goodwill in Burlington, North Carolina, I was extremely hyped cop. Anyways, I probably paid $7 for it.
It's a come up, G.
My big outfit formula is jeans, a t-shirt, and sneakers. So just always Levi. Typically, they got a nice 512s that fit me.
It's one of the best denim companies ever.
Yes, sir. And on brand, got Nike Vapor Max.
Yep. Very comfortable.
Very comfortable.
Fly knit upper.
Yeah, very nice.
Nice.
Perfect. Perfect shoe for going to the airport. Mm. Perfect shoe to get, snacks.
Okay.
And just overall a nice. It's a statement because people know like this is a nice expensive shoe.
Yep.
But it's not like overwhelming to where you know it gets you in trouble.
It's 160 MSRP. I think those.
Yeah,
are.
Something like that. So and then I got the Amelion Dior. You know, what I'm saying
that's a nice pickup. It's a $70 t-shirt. Geez.
Once again, a little bit more than that, but we won't tell. We won't tell everybody.
It's
business.
At least 70.
Yeah, at least.
And it's cotton.
Oh, very comfortable. Got this in Soho.
Speaking of cotton, you're wearing a 1619 hat, 40 acres and a mule. What's up?
Yeah. Shout out to Spike Lee. Shout out to anti-slavery.
Anti-slavery.
But yeah, man, this is my fit. You know, we have nothing else to do in this quarantine. So I get genuinely excited to get dressed for this damn show.
You look great, man.
Thank you. What you got on?
Man, I don't know. Tom Sachs head to toe. I got actually Let's Do Better socks, hat, collab. Appreciate you. David Rasul Robinson, shout out. Appreciate you for the hat, my G. Got a Tom Sachs shop tee from the Japan collab tee ceremony. I got some Champion pants, and I got like the Tom Sachs, overshoe. You know what I'm saying? I'm out here. it's winter, it's snow, you know, I like to be technical. So, yeah, that's what we're doing today.
I meant to ask you, I also meant to ask you about those shoes when I saw them.
It's a hated on shoe.
Really? People didn't like them?
They didn't. It's like one of those shoes, it's like if it was $150, people would buy them.
Yeah.
But the fact that it's like $300 retail
or
so, people are like, oh, they find ways to hate on it.
I liked them when they came out. I thought they were very unique and very hard. I mean, I tried to get them, but I didn't get them. Mm. But those are very tough. Thing about shopping and when things, we talk about this every episode, I feel like, things come around almost always.
Every week.
So if you like something, it touches you, it's a great chance that maybe it's not this week or 2 weeks or whatever. This year or next year or whatever year, it's going to come around where like, oh, you got the damn.
Yeah, dude, it'll come back.
So I like those a lot. I meant to ask about that. But today we got a dope, every episode of the pop-up, we are giving talking about steals, great steals here in the pop-up shop that are going to be of our very, very limited time.
Right.
So this week, last week we did the all black forces,
we did the all triple blacks.
And this week, I think this is another very classic, necessary, need to have shoe. 20% off
Air Maxes, man. So shout out to the chat right now for the pop-up TV. In the chat pinned, you should see a direct link to our Air Maxes. We typically sell Air Maxes for $87 in the shop. So 1987 is when the shoe originally came out, designed by Tinker Hatfield. And we're running a 20% off sale. So like the shoe, I think MSRP is 120, 130. We're already selling it for 87. And then we're dropping another 20% off. So you could find a potential steal. I could talk about this shoe all night. It's my favorite shoe.
Give me some game on it, though. I was so funny enough getting prepared for tonight's episode. We all know about Air Maxes in general. But Nike did a really good release or story on it earlier in 2020 when they released, I guess, the 2090s that came out last year. So anyways, it was Clark Kent, a bunch of people that were on that that piece Nike did. But give me some game about these Air Max.
So the Air Max 1, Nike, you know, it's the first Air Max that came out in 1987. This shoe was designed by a man named Tinker Hatfield. Tinker was inspired by the Pompidou Center in France, in Paris. So it's a building that has all the components of the building exposed, right? So like all the plumbing is exposed, all the elevators are exposed, all the air ducts are exposed, right? So he was inspired by that to do an exposed Air Max. So this is the actual first time Nike as a company had shown their consumers what type of technology was in the system. So you can see everybody knows it's it's common to see air now, but this is the first time it was done, 1987. I can talk about this all day, but like, I just think the shoe is just so iconic because of its simplicity.
Yeah.
You know, it has quite a few panels. The OGs are, you know, mesh toe box, suede toe cap, suede back heel cup, and a very comfortable shoe. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I think I have at least...
Don't tell on yourself now.
40?
Damn.
I have at least 40 that I can probably rattle off right now, 40 pairs of Air Max 1s
right
in my collection. So it's my favorite shoe. So again, like, if you're into it, if you're really looking for a trainer, right? Like, if you're from Europe, if you're watching from Europe, these are called trainers or creps. But here in the States, we just call them Air Maxes. But this is the one. I mean, they've made, 87s, which are these. They've made 90s, 95s. But it always comes back to the Air Max 1 for me. So this is my favorite shoe, which is why we're running a special tonight.
Crazy, crazy shoe. And I was watching that little piece Nike did, to know that now we've been spoiled to kind of see that air piece.
Right.
We're used to it now. Right. And now we're so used to it. So that was really cool for not only for me to watch that, but for you to reiterate that. But yeah, man, 20% off for the duration of the show, man. So if you're, once again, this is a great time to shop. Valentine's Day is coming up. If you got any significant others that like shoes.
I mean, you're getting shoes for like $70. I mean, the retailing out, like, I think it's $140.
Yeah.
So you can get it for 50% off. It's up to you if you find your size online. The link is pinned in the chat. Let's go.
What else are we doing? So I really appreciate the pop-up, man. And the show is we're doing more and more stuff incorporated with the show.
Right.
One of the dopest things, we got all this Nike stuff, and then there's a random stack of Adidas
look at it.
Boxes here.
That's uncommon.
So kind of put us up on game with I know you are running a raffle for the shoes. So kind of, what's going on, man?
Man, okay. So look, I appreciate you saying that. I just think we're all really blessed. You know, we're out here. It's all, you're a homie, Gabe's a homie, and everyone like kind of supporting the business is all my friends or my family. So, you know, one of the OGs from Chicago, like we did a podcast in the space a couple weeks back with our friends from Face Value, Kurt and Perry. Shout out to Kurt and Perry from Face Value. Y'all have an amazing podcast.
That I watched, I was telling Gabe, Gabe shot it. I watched that episode and it was a dope. I don't know, man. I just love seeing things done in the culture and spaces. And that, I appreciated just watching it, but even listening to it, listening to
those
to
dudes Vic. Know a lot.
Yeah.
Those dudes know a lot. And like, you know, Chicago's always kind of like the underdog, and like the knowledge and the domain expertise here is tight. So I won't spend too much time on that. But they had, they used our space to do an interview with Vic Lloyd. Vic Lloyd is, you know, one of the Fat Tigers, Fat Tiger Workshop here in Chicago on Milwaukee Avenue. He's an OG dog. Like he's done a lot in the city, and he blessed us with some shoes, man. Like he did it. I mean, look, Vic, if you're watching, we appreciate you. For All-Star Week last year, Vic did two shoes. He did the Forum Low and he did a Superstar. This is the Forum Low, and he blessed us with a few pair. This particular pair, what he was inspired by when Adidas asked him to do this collaboration was, like kind of how he grew up, how he played basketball in the hood. You know, milk crates on you know, electrical poles and, you know, jumping over recycling bins and, you know, posting up trash guys and shit like that. So, no, for real. That's what the
mouse in the house.
You know what I'm saying? That's what inspired him for these, right? So, like, that's kind of what this shoe was. And, you know, just off the strength of the interview he did with Face Value, I was like, yo, man, like, let's just try to do something. He just kind of blesses with these shoes. So,
yeah.
We have several pair of these tonight, and we ran a raffle, you know, this past week just to, you know, get, you know, give back to the culture, give back to people all around that are kind of ride with the business, the pop-up. Yeah. So, you know, we did a little raffle this past week where we're giving away a few pair of these, you know, to guests that want to show up and enter the raffle, and we have some names to like, raffle off tonight.
But also.
Yeah.
Also.
In the show.
For you people that are listening.
For people that are listening.
Right now.
Right now.
There's a fantastic chance that we are going to give away a pair to you.
Let's go.
All right. I feel like one of those like old preachers and those like infomercials at like 2 o'clock in the morning. Like,
you watch those?
No, but you know, you have to go like pee when you're like 13 and it's like some weird, creepy white guy like you that just woke up.
Right. I remember.
I see you. Yeah.
I remember.
There's a chance. There's a calling.
That's I'm hilarious, calling. Man.
I can feel you. But no, so what we're going to do, people that are on the chat,
yeah,
drop your size, drop your city
okay.
that you're in right now, and there's a fantastic chance that you can walk away or get mailed to at least a pair of of these shoes.
Listen, again, I think we have 13 people watching right now live streaming, so the candidate pool is really small, right, frankly? Ooh. Oh,
yeah, somebody pulled up. Sochelle Builder, shout out to you, man.
Sochelle, shout out. We appreciate you. We just appreciate you. Thank you. For people in the chat, your city that you're from currently, the size shoe that you wear, we will select one winner, and we will mail you a free pair of the Vic Lloyd Adidas Forum Lows.
That's a come
off
up.
Rip, off rip. It's a come up. Just pulling up to the show. And we trying to do, this is what we're trying to build, right?
Look, I wouldn't be spending my time telling these weak ass jokes, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Getting dressed, putting jeans on. It's a pandemic. For me to put jeans on,
okay,
I got to be really passionate about something, okay?
Okay. I feel you.
What Kevin's doing over here at the pop-up shop is some really
man, I appreciate
cool
you, man.
Shit. But nah, but for real though, I think this is great, man. You know, opportunity for you to engage with people, and you know, for like you said, Chicago. I'm I'm 5 years into Chicago, okay. So I'm not a Chicago native by any means. Yeah. I'm from the Midwest, but there's something different in the water or the snow or the fucking hot dogs in Chicago. Water. Yeah, that like I think that is really cool that someone that maybe may or may not be from Chicago can get some shoes for free. So give your size, your city, and we'll try to hook you up with some free shoes.
We'll hook you up. That's what.
Grind my gears. All right,
ooh,
so.
Man, I'm ready.
Grind my gears. The biggest grind my gearing this past week or two since we last recorded, those Notre Dunks. We talked about the Notre Dunks.
We did. We talked about them last time we did the show.
And I was excited about them. I was optimistic. I think that maybe me saying it on the show made them sell out faster.
You think so?
It's a great chance. Yeah.
You influence the culture that much.
I think what we're building here is tremendous.
I agree with you.
I think that
I love tremendous is an under-leveraged word. You know, I love that word.
Make tremendous great
again.
We're
supposed to be mad because we're grinding our gears, right?
Yeah, I'm sorry. So anyway,
get back and
carry. So the Notre Dunks, both colorways. I didn't get them. I struck out on the Notre website and struck out on sneakers. But we talked about this in pre-production. I want to give a shout out to Notre because on the website dropped a couple days before sneakers, they did something a little different.
What'd they do?
So when you came to the website,
okay,
the website wasn't live.
Yep.
When you went to Notre.com.
Mm-hmm.
And then you had to refresh.
Yep.
And then once it was refreshed, it was you could click on the shoes, and then I think it was like one of those capture things where it's like whatever circle has a dog in it, and it's like, damn, am I a fucking robot? Like you go through that whole thing, and you click it, and you go through it. And then also they asked, what city is Notre in?
Yeah.
You know, Chicago.
Yep.
And it was nice to see that they really cared about people not being able to get through the body, like get these shoes
through body.
You really had to know at least something about the brand.
Exactly.
Because it's a lot of times where I bought stuff, I didn't know where necessarily the store was from, if I'm not from that city.
That's interesting.
You know what I'm saying?
So I know exactly what you're saying.
So I want to ask you, like, we talked about it a little bit before the show, but even though I was upset I didn't get them, I wasn't as mad because, like, they tried to make it fair for everybody to cop.
You know, they did. And you know, I think all of the shops in Chicago do a really good job of trying to keep things here locally before they open up the bot, you know, open up the square, the Shopify to get botted, you know, so, you know, to get botted, you know, so like, I'm happy that they did that. You know, I'm salty that I didn't get them, but I was thinking about it. I didn't really need them, you know, like I like them to be real. So like not to squash your, your grind your gears, but like, I didn't need them. You know, I have a bunch of shoes. I have a bunch of dunks, and they're great. They're fantastic. But one of my good homies here in Chicago, I won't share any names. When we were talking about it in chat, he mentioned to me they're like similar to the, I think they're like the J. Crew did some dunks, or like was it J. Crew? It was a big house that did like natural color dunk.
You know,
a few years ago. So it was like how is that any different, really? Now, granted, I do get it. You know, the campaign behind it, the handshake, that's dope.
Yeah.
And it was suede. But it's not as if it was like a groundbreaking shoe in hindsight. Now, granted, like, that's me being the salty me because I didn't get them. If I had them, I'd be wearing them right now and flexing.
Right.
So I'm trying to find reasons why I didn't like them, to be honest. So if anybody from Notre's watching, any of my homies that work there, I apologize. But they're cool. But I'm not mad. I'm not like angry that I didn't get them.
Yeah, I think we all have those. Like for me, I'm salty about not getting those. But I know exactly what you're saying. There's shoes that you feel like I would like to have them as a part of my, you know, my
collection,
vibe, my moment, my whatever. But also, when you don't get them, it's like, I could live without them because it might be similar to something else you have or whatever. So I get it. I'm still and was upset about not getting them. But it's just, once again, we talked about this before. It's nice to see shops getting these collaborations. with these big brands, the Nike. I feel like most of us grew up wanting and loving Nike.
Yeah.
Big brother Nike. So, mm-hmm. you know, shout out to Notra, but my gears are fucking grinded.
Yeah.
Anything to grind your gears this week at all?
The GameStop, like the whole short selling wave that happened the past 4 days that I missed out on because I was busy working two jobs, having two kids, and being married, trying to start a show and all that type of stuff. I'm not mad. My gears have been grinded with no grease.
Right, right, right.
Because usually I would be deep into like Twitter or deep into Reddit, whatever I'm in, and I just missed out on some bread, you know? Yeah. But
a little bit.
A lot of bit.
A lot of bit. A lot of bit, bread.
Yo, I was trying to sign up for it's called Doggy Coin.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was trying to sign up on Kraken. The site kept crashing, but it went from like 0.001 cents to like 6 cents. And if you threw like a good 1K in there.
Yeah. $10,000.
It makes sense to all this shit just to throw like $50 into anything.
Yeah. I was watching something. You know? Like, I couldn't sleep last night because I was preparing for the show.
Right.
No, I'm joking. But I was up like 3 a.m. and I was watching CNBC. And they were talking about how with this whole, they were giving like their own take on this thing.
Yeah.
Like the short sell stuff. And it was like, just be comfortable with what you're okay to lose. And if you're okay with that, then you won't be like a huge miss if you, you know,
right.
fall short on some stuff. So.
Yeah. Shout out to Robin Hood. Well, non-shout out to Robin Hood. Yeah, man,
Robin Hood, yo.
I'm a cash out.
That's actually not Robin Hood.
Right, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Right, that's like...
For context.
Yeah, that's Robin the Hood. Robin yeah, brother, Hood, see, what you got to yeah. do is...
Right.
Robin Hood is Robin the Hood. Yeah. Now, see, y'all thought y'all was coming here to buy sneakers, my brothers and sisters. Actually, it's time for church.
It's time for church.
So zoom in on me a little bit more. No. No, bro. I mean, I think... Look, we should not be surprised about anything that goes on. I don't want to make this depressing, but we shouldn't be surprised anything that's not for the people.
Yeah,
that thinks it's for the people.
Right,
that goes to clothes. Mm-hmm. You know how this shit is. Like, people can say they're for something and do a commercial with Colin Kaepernick and do right. and be uniformed for the NFL. It doesn't matter. So, long story short, that was definitely, I also agree, grinding my gears. Mm-hmm. But real quick, a chat update. Shout out to Jared.
Shout out to Social Builder. Okay. Shout out to Luis. We appreciate you. Shout out to Amanda. You stumbled upon our shop and met with an awesome place, hospital, showed us around, power couple. We love you too, Amanda.
That's cool, man.
Thank you so much. That means a lot. Thank you. We appreciate you.
That's super cool, man. Yeah. You know, we talked about this on my podcast, is building something with your people and with your family. So shout out to you and Molly, man. You know, black owned, women led.
Let's go.
You know, shop here in the West Loop.
Multitasking.
But that's super tight. But also,
Les, can we give away a pair of shoes right now?
Yeah, we can do that.
Let's do it. Okay.
Next time we're putting a sound effect on.
We're putting a sound effect.
I know. I'm sorry. I meant to add something on the board.
Yeah.
And the only thing that's on the board now is like a mac and cheese sound, which it's the yellow button. I think it's the yellow button.
I'm pressing it.
Nah, you're about to blow up the whole John G.
Is it mac and cheese?
Nah, I'll press it once. I'm just going to.
Oh, okay. All right. Yeah. It's a random mac and cheese sound. Sorry. Look, it's not anything.
You're wild, dog.
It's legitimately a mac and cheese sound on my soundboard.
But why do you have it programmed to your thing, though?
Okay.
You don't need to stop. Okay. Hey, so look. Okay, guess. We'll bring it back. We're sorry. Okay.
My bad.
I want to give away a pair of shoes.
Yeah, man. Let's do it.
Let's see who we got. Okay. So what I have available outside of the pairs that we're going to give away, I think I have a 9.5. So Social Builder, we're going to send you a pair of shoes.
Let's go.
We're going to send you a brand new pair of Vic Lloyd Adidas Forum Lows with the signed box, so a sign by the designer himself, Chicago's own Vic Lloyd. We'll send those to you soon. I'm going to DM you and get your contact information so we can reach out to you. But we'll take note of that, and we'll follow up with you after the show. So shout out to Social Builder. You're the first winner tonight. We got a couple more to go.
To make it easier,
yeah.
Just DM. We'll get his name down, but also DM us at thepopup.com.
Yeah, DM us.
On Social Instagram. Builder,
we got you. Thank you. Simplify the process.
Yeah, so DM us at the pop up dot.
Yep.
You got
it? Yeah, we got it. We got it. Yeah. He
the
can spell.
Pop up.
Yep.
D-O-T.
He went to private school, by the way.
C-O-M. And also play football and have a lot of CTE. So.
Ooh. Yeah, we're not hating on that.
But we're definitely getting you those shoes. So okay. DM us and we'll get them to you. I'm excited, man.
What are you excited about?
You're very, very welcome, So Shell. I'm just excited to give away free stuff.
Me
you
too.
Know, there's a lot of scams. Okay. I make a lot of my comedy, as you know, is based off of making fun of scams.
Okay.
But there's no scam in here.
There's no scams.
Just to pull up, hang out with us.
Just hang out.
On the chat.
We're going to send you stuff.
And we're going to send some shoes. But so anyways, Gabe, can we get into some topics?
Let's talk about Bernie. Okay. The Bernie meme? Let's talk about it. What you want to talk about, Gabe?
Sorry, I put the mic on. So we got Bernie sweatshirts. Bernie sweatshirts.
The meme.
Sold out.
Yeah, so my dog Bernie, this is related to what we've been talking about.
Yep.
With a moment, which is Bernie Sanders pulling up to the inauguration, pissed off, and orders about his business.
Mm-hmm.
The internet went crazy with him.
It did.
I'm on the same energy. Bernie's whole vibe was me at when I had my old job, like at work, like all in meetings. Like, bro, y'all hurry
up.
I got shit to do. I got stuff to do.
I got things to complain about.
I got a comedy set. My dog is hungry.
Yeah.
I'm hungover. All those moments that you with the legs.
Yep.
And when you get older and you can finally cross your legs over, that's when you know I'm in my bag. Like, all right, I don't need to do this, but I'm here just to do it. But he flipped that meme into a sweatshirt.
Okay.
And then all the proceeds are getting donated, right? So is there a charity, Gabe?
Yeah, I believe it's Meals on Wheels Vermont. Yeah, that's where he's at. So
shout out to Bernie.
Yeah, I mean, I copped one.
Really?
You did?
Yeah, I got one on real quick. I think I still got it. They sent me an email. But yeah, all that money, it was $48 sweatshirt. So you can only imagine they probably sent a good amount of money.
Yeah.
To the charity.
That's awesome.
It's so easy to do, right?
It's
by
so
people.
Easy to do.
And even if he wanted to keep the money for whatever reason,
right?
Merch in general, it's so nice to be able to take advantage of a moment and like monetize it.
I 2000% agree. It's nice to take advantage of a moment. I think there's already like a few Bernie memes that are like used quite a bit. You know what I'm saying? So to like have him on this with this particular thing at the time, I thought it was just pretty funny. And that's also something I think that 5 years from now, it won't be cringeworthy. It'll still be like, it'll still stand the test of time. Oh, you remember where you were when X, you know what I'm saying?
Oh,
I thought that was pretty funny.
Cause it's a mood that a lot of us feel in America. Like I'm here cause I want to see what happens, but I'm also not in a great mood.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like I'm here cause I'm American, but damn, this shit's kind of
sus.
Wild still,
it's super sus. Yeah. It's super sus. Yeah.
So, you know, I think that was cool. Also, before we keep going into news, do you want to announce any of the raffle winners?
Let's do it.
Sorry,
all right.
Dave.
Yeah,
we didn't get a chance to announce
any
of the raffle.
Great call, Danny. So, like I mentioned earlier in the show, we had a raffle that we did earlier this week with Vic Lloyd, our friend here at Fat Tiger Workshop. He donated several pairs of his collaboration with Adidas, the Forum Low, representing like Chicago alleyway construction site basketball. So we're going to give away on the show. We decided in the raffle this past week, we're going to give away 3 pair. So we're going to call out over the course of the show, 3 individuals that entered the raffle by linking 3 friends, liking the chat, and then signing up for the forum in our bio. So we'll hop into that right now. The first winner is an individual by the name of Makeupin Maria. Maria. Maria, I'll make sure I DM you this weekend, get your contact information, and we'll send you a free pair of these Forum Lows in your size. Congratulations. We appreciate you and we appreciate the support.
Shout out Maria.
Thank you.
This is fan.
You know, like a drink champs thing. Woo!
Yeah. shots, Nori. Shots. Hold on. The funny thing, I love Drink Champs because motherfuckers be in the middle of like the most passionate story. He'd be like, hold on, shots. Hold on, I gotta drink shots. He's like, Nori, I'm telling you about this one story. Michael Jackson and Michael Jordan and Jesus were in the same room in at the same time. Yeah. And he'd be, hold on. Shots. Let me get a blunt. But hold on, Nori. But I love that, the vibe of Drink Champs.
I love it.
We need to. This is a sneaker Jeep champ.
It is
Drink Champs.
Yeah.
Shout
so
out to
so far. We're keeping track. We've given away two free pairs of shoes.
Yeah.
In about 5 minutes.
Look, bro.
That's right.
You know, I'm not gonna say this is a thrift store because it's not.
Mm-hmm.
But the fun of there's a value in going to a curated space. Yep. You got the best shit you can find. Well, there's also that fun in like I'm going into something. And I'm finding stuff that I didn't expect to find, especially when it's free. So thank you for watching.
I mean, it's just kind of like, do y'all remember when you were shorties? I don't know the audience, what decade y'all grew up in. I grew up in the 90s, so I'm old. I'm washed. It's okay. But I remember going to the mall. My mom dropped me off at the mall. Bro, me and my
malls.
Brother.
Remember with like, malls in general?
Never Shit. Forget malls. My mom would drop my brother off at the mall at Tell 12 Mall in Southfield, Michigan. She would drop us off. With $20, that $20 was to feed us at Chick-fil-A, use the extra money we had at the arcade, so we had to be selective with what we bought.
Yeah.
And part of our journey to the mall was to go to Foot Locker to, like, just look at every single thing, right, and just have conversations with the salespeople. So I think what we're trying to build as a business is the same thing, like actual subject matter experts talking about the shoes when they came out, the technology, that type of stuff, the materials, and just having fun. Like, it shouldn't be like, I'm going to wait in line, you know, to go into a shop and get, you know, hit over the head on a price. It's more like finding deals, you know what I'm saying? It's more like having fun and just like building relationships.
Yeah,
that's really what it's about. Especially in Chicago. You can't necessarily get that same type of vibe in different parts of the country, which is why I love living here, bro.
Bro, that's nothing like going shopping like on Mag Mile and like you go into a store and it's like, bro, I'm not even, I'm employed, so I, you know, can bought my girl gifts and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
You go into like a luxury shop, and it's like, you just gotta take a deep breath because it's like, you know,
this is what it is. I'm about to get hit over the head.
Yeah, and it's also like the vibe of the person that's helping you make this decision.
They don't know what they're selling.
It's like, bro, it's a lot of money for me, bro. Yeah. Thousands of dollars potentially.
Allegedly. Not everybody got it like that, Danny. You just outed yourself.
I said allegedly.
Oh, that's your caveat.
Yeah, not me.
Not you? Not with the Dream Team jacket on?
This was $7 in North Carolina.
Okay.
At Goodwill.
Speaking of tens of dollars, maybe.
Okay.
Shout out. What's new?
Man, you know what's new, man? What's really new, and I'm really proud to talk about it.
You stepping up, man.
You stepping up, man. Cheers, man. Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? We out here.
Shout out to Crystal Head Vodka. It's our first sponsor on the show. Crystal Head Vodka really pulled up on us last week and we're like, you know, we really like what y'all doing. So we're going to like put on for y'all. So Crystal Head Vodka has given us quite a bit of product. This iridescent bottle, this one right here, is called the Aurora. This particular bottle of vodka is made from wheat. This is a cool bottle.
It's the one in the middle if you're looking.
This is super cool. This super cool bottle. Shout out to Crystal Head. Yeah. Okay. Crystal Head Vodka, iridescent bottle, Skullhead. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, distilled from wheat. They have a bunch of talking points, but basically there's no additives in this vodka, you know, so it's really like super pure. The one over to the right is the original. The original is made from corn. Shout out to Iowa. I know my wife is watching. She's from Iowa. So
woo!
Shout out to Iowa. Shout out to corn, the corn vodka joint.
Woo!
That's their original. That's their entry level, right? So that's one you can go get at most of your retailers here, at least in the Chicago area, Chicagoland area, Midwest. And then the cream of the crop is the Onyx, this black one. It's made from agave. Mm. So this one, you know, that's kind of what we're drinking tonight. You know, we have the premium agave joint that they gave us. So more than anything, Crystal Head, we appreciate you. And we encourage those of you at home that are of age, that consume alcohol. Give
you're
it a shot.
You're not of age. Close your eyes.
Give it a shot. It's pretty good. No cap.
No, yeah, but I'm typically a dark liquor guy, but this is delicious, man. So not shout bad. Out. And this is cool for brands. I work in podcasting, and brands and ads and shit in real life. So it's cool when you really can have a brand that sponsors you that really knows and appreciates what you're doing. So
yeah,
I'm excited for us just in general to
grow, man.
To grow.
Yeah.
Catch vibes.
It's exciting, man.
As well. But
what are y'all drinking with it? Real quick.
What is this? Lemonade?
It's a gimlet. So
it's a vibe.
Our bartender, shout out to Darius. Darius does it. So we have, again, the show, the team, what you see is Danny and I talking stuff on camera.
There's a whole squad
behind the camera that actually makes all this work.
Johnny Fresh was in the chat earlier.
Johnny Fresh
was
in the chat. He's definitely like an OG on the team. Shout out to Darius. Darius is kind of does some back end stuff for us, but he actually mixed these drinks.
You see this coat? He came with that coat. I said, damn.
Johnny dropping merch. You know what I'm saying? Johnny, don't forget about us, G.
Yeah, that coat. I said, okay, that's a coat.
You talking about Darius's coat?
Yeah. Darius and Lil.
What do you say?
You see this coat?
You wild, dog.
That's funny as hell.
Let's go. Let's go. All right, cool. But no, we appreciate the team that's at home, you know, chiming in. But also, last thing I'll say about Crystal Head, like, you know, we appreciate y'all. You know, and
yeah,
you know, thanks for like really just showing up. And you know what actually is the funniest thing about it?
Oh yeah, please, yeah. This
you fact. Know what it is?
It's cool fact.
Fucking Dan Aykroyd.
Dan Aykroyd is a founder or co-founder of this?
Is a co-founder of Crystal Head Vodka.
The Ghostbusters dude, the fucking trading. This week has felt like Trading Places. Like,
why is that?
With the GameStop shit and all this, I feel like there's some kind of documentary going to come out with Eddie Murphy, and he's like 60, and Dan Aykroyd, and it's on Wall Street.
Jamie Lee Curtis.
Yeah, Jamie Lee Curtis. Yeah, it's a hooker. Yeah, whatever. Yeah. It's just like, oh, what's going on? It's like, oh, sorry. It was the sequel to Trading Places.
Yeah.
That's classic Eddie Murphy movie.
That's a great connection right there. I'm glad you made that connection.
Look, SNL, hire me as a writer, because that should be the cold open to this fucking week's episode.
It should.
Is Trading Places Part 2. But right. You know what? Y'all not paying.
Eddie Murphy on the skateboard with moving around.
Like, could you imagine? great classic movie. You want to learn about stocks and bonds at a high level? Dan, look at this. Go back to that picture, Gabe.
You going back?
This is my man.
Dan, if Aykroyd. I was an old white guy, I would definitely have a nice comb over.
What was your favorite Ghostbuster?
I don't know.
Say Winston. I'll say Egon. Egon was the brains behind the operation. Egon had the coldest haircut, that poof joint. He had glasses, and he always knew, like, not to cross the polarity. You don't cross the polarity, it'll create blah, 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 something. I forget. But that was my favorite Ghostbuster. Me and my brother grew up on that.
I need to rewatch Ghostbuster because it's been a minute since I watched, and I didn't get those references.
Okay. Well, we'll move past that.
I feel like Trading Places is older than that, so it's just me not. But anyways, shout out to Skullhead. Shout out to Dan Aykroyd.
Appreciate
hustling.
You. Yep.
We need to get the pop-up TV, something to sell other than clothes.
Y'all want to do another raffle giveaway? How y'all feeling?
What about the chat?
We got about 20 minutes left in the...
What about the chat? Does the chat want a free pair of shoes?
Yeah, how's the chat feeling?
How's the chat feeling about that?
Drop the size that you wear.
And your city.
And your city.
Yep, we're trying to be diverse.
Yep. And we can keep going, but drop them joints into the chat. And then we'll check back into the chat in a second.
Yep.
But one thing that I did watch this week that I think it may be a little bit late news, the Louis Vuitton Virgil.
He came up with some new shoes.
Did you watch it?
The
Fashion Week?
I did not watch it.
So I watched it.
Yep.
And I encourage anybody else to watch it.
Okay.
And it felt different. And mind you, I'm not someone that has watched a bunch of fashion. I mean, I've watched fashion shows, get me wrong.
Yeah.
Shout out to Alex, our homie Alex, Alex Webb, because he was like, go watch Pierre Moss's old fashion show. Great. When they were in the rain or something like that. But we're going to get that in a second.
Damn, they snap with this.
But the whole fashion show, I guess the Paris, it was Paris Fashion Week.
Yeah.
And so I guess there wasn't any people around or whatever. Mm-hmm. It was pretty much shot like a movie. And it was such a different experience to see clothes in that way.
Mm-hmm.
As I was watching it with my wife, I was like, I wonder how many of these people are models versus dancers.
Ooh.
Because it was like the way they were wearing the clothes, it was different, bro. And the way the shots were being made, it was different to where it made you really feel like it was on some Wizard of Oz shit, but like 2030.
Wow.
Because, you know, runway clothes, they're supposed to be loud. It's supposed to be statements.
Yep.
But to see them in that kind of space,
yep,
in the whole set design, bro, like, I advise you to watch it, bro. It was inspirational.
That's a massive statement. You know, I really love Virgil. Like, I'm not even gonna front. Like, you know, people hate. I think he's awesome.
You're supposed to hate, though. You get that much money, you're supposed to hate.
I agree with you. I just think, you know, he, like, my close circle of friends and I have conversations about this all the time, which he gets hated on for, which is repurposing things, you know, and, like, not being super original, but just remixing things. And I think, like, having that mindset is tired, right? Because at the end of the day, there's really nothing new you can do because you're inspired by something.
Right.
You live on Earth. You have content coming into your phone and TV. You're going to be inspired by something. So
everything's remixed.
Everyone
has two arms, two legs. Mm-hmm. Everyone, you know, these cities that we've lived in.
Right.
I think, and even like the going back, even like there was something about Timberland. People, like, it was a side by side where Timberland. People were playing the originals of some old school, like, Timberland songs he produced.
Mm-hmm.
And people were, like, upset about it. It's like, bro, that's culture in general, to be able to take a piece of something and repurpose it. That's almost, like, good for the environment, whether it's physical or, like, in space, that, like, mm-hmm. we use things. We use people's likeness. Tesla. The name Tesla didn't come from nowhere.
Yeah, it came from...
Some motherfucking name Tesla is
dead.
It
came from Nikola Tesla.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I watched The Prestige, you know?
Right. Somebody
look at you.
Yeah.
Look at you.
So we got a couple of people. Atina. No, Atina does not count. So
Atina,
we'll
I'm sorry, sweetheart.
Go to the next. No, I'm playing.
No, we love you. We love you, but
no,
that would
thanks,
be.
Atina. No, but we got a couple of people.
What about.
Twice. Drop your.
Oh, what's up? Oh, that's my boy, Brandon. What's up, boy? Yeah,
okay.
Drop your.
Let's see.
Size,
what
bro.
About. I see Fort Worth, Texas in there. What's up with Fort Worth, Texas? JRayo05. You know what, G? I don't know if you're a male or a female, but we're going to send you a free pair of shoes.
Woo, America.
I'm going to take care of you, okay? Fort Worth. I used to work in Fort Worth when I worked for General Electric. There's a railroad manufacturing facility there, like a train engine manufacturing facility.
Nice.
And I also really love Texas because I love Pimp C. I love Chopped and Screwed music as well. So
yeah, Texas
I'm
is
biased,
a different little
vibe. I'm biased to Texas. So pro tip, if you're in here, we're giving free giveaways. If you say anything about Pimp C or Texas or Screw Chopped and Screwed music, you're going to get something. So
everything is bigger. I feel like if I move, my daddy lives in the suburbs of Dallas, DeSoto.
Yep.
And as soon as I pulled up, I wanted to get like a big ass truck and just like cowboy boots. And there's a church on every corner of Texas.
There
like
is,
Texas.
Man. Yeah.
Beautiful, beautiful place. But yeah, DM us. We'll get your name down. But DM us on Instagram at thepopup.com. Spelled that all the way out. DOTCOM.
So far we got SoShell Builders getting a free pair and JRayo05. Send us the chat in our Instagram with your contact information. We'll take care of you in the next couple of days. We appreciate you.
I feel like a skinny version of Oprah. Sorry, that was... Cut that out, Gabe. Sorry. Cut that out.
Rewind.
But speaking of... is Pierre Pyre Moss?
Pierre.
Pierre Moss.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because it's supposed to be like it's I, but it's a Y. Auntie Kamala.
Yeah, man. What's up with
Kamala?
That?
We did it, Joe.
We did it. We're going to be the next best shoe show in America. We did it. We did it.
Yeah.
That's what we need to remix next. That's the next commercial we need to remix.
Yeah. They don't know.
I know.
You'll know soon.
Yeah.
You don't know right now.
we're going to be the next best.
We're working on something.
Sneaker shop. Joe. Anyway, in the whole inauguration in general, I mean, really more so was Kamala and Michelle.
Yeah, they snap. Fits.
For Melania to have been a supermodel and we never really talked about it in 4 years is a shame.
They did on other networks. They talked about it.
But as far as the culture of movements,
mm-hmm.
all it took was like one little cookout
mm-hmm.
and the streets were talking about their fits, and it felt good. It felt like how Obama felt that moment of like, damn, this motherfucker tan suits, you know, like that. It was like that. It restored the feeling, bro.
Yeah, you can't. I mean, you know what I'm saying? Like the same old template. I'm waiting for them to do business casual at the White House, G.
Oh, bro,
like, I mean, come on, man.
The, you see the Dior ones?
I seen them. That was Kamala's nephew.
Yeah, or yeah. son-in-law. Whatever, nephew,
whatever he was. He had $2,000 shoes on. G.
That is the thing. Yeah. That is.
It's the wave, man.
That's the pinnacle, the peak. That's if I'm that dude, yeah. whoever that is. You know he was on the phone with his boy. Yeah, I'm finna kill him.
I'm about to be at the inauguration. I'm about to kill him. Let me hit stock.
Right, real quick. You know, Auntie already, you know, she got that little shit. So I'm finna pull up on these boys. You already know he was hype.
He was hype, G.
That's the culture. That's the culture at the highest international level.
I'm gonna tell you what. When I walk into my shop every day, I treat it like a fashion show. So I can't imagine being at an inauguration, a presidential inauguration. Just, you know what I'm saying, to like. Make that juke. So yeah, man. I mean, shout out to the whole situation. The past couple weeks has been fire.
You see this coat? Sorry, Derry, I'm gonna say that. You see this coat?
It came out dripping. Remind the audience about the sale you got going on real quick.
Yeah.
We got about 12 minutes left in the show, but okay. Yeah, let them know.
Thanks for the shameless plug, Gabe. We appreciate you. We're selling Air Maxes today, y'all. We're selling everything. Everything's for sale. What we're running tonight during the course of the show is a deal on Air Max 1s. We have several Air Max 1s on our web store right now. They're priced at $87. During the duration of this show, we're selling this pair of shoes for 20% less than that, not including shipping or fees. But we'll send that out to you within 24 hours. Small team, but we make it work. Again, the Air Max 1, to me, is the best shoe ever made. I think the second best shoe ever made is the Air Force 1, but that is the best shoe. 1987, it still stands the test of time. They still make countless pairs, different materials, different collaborations. It's an iconic shoe, and we're giving it to you for the low.
What's your favorite colorway?
My favorite model of that shoe is the Amsterdam. It came out in 2000 and
Pada.
That's where, you know, because that's the store there in Amsterdam. You know, they did a collaboration. So yeah, one of the best. One of the best ever made. Early 2000s.
Something about some of these classic, when somebody does it right.
Yeah.
It's such a beautiful kind of, whatever that magic is when something happens. It's just like, anyways. Yeah, the pop-up. The link is in the chat, Gabe, if it's not already buried in the chat. I know somebody, I think Sochelle already copped a pair already.
Sochelle got a pair.
Make sure you take advantage of that. And on top of, once you go to the link, there's a bunch of other dope stuff on the shop as well, thepopup.com.
And if you're here locally.
Pull up.
Like, that's the thing, right? That's the kind of finesse. If you're here locally, You can catch a bunch of different stuff that we have in, and not all of us on the website, because we like that. Like I was mentioning earlier, we like that going to the mall, coming across something that you weren't expecting. I try to keep that element of the shop live and active.
Right.
But, you know, over time we sprinkle new items in the web store. So every week you're going to see like 10, 20, 25, depending on how much schoolwork Darius has, you know what I'm saying? Well, I want to give Darius a shout out. Y'all don't see him. Darius, right? Right now he's behind the scenes, does the web, does the e-commerce, does the website, does all the photography for the brand. This man came in today
drip
with a Coke white Supreme steep tech jacket.
You see this coat?
I mean, he shut it down. Like one stain on that, John. Look at him, much love. Right. One stain on that love, it's a wrap. But like Darius,
Stormtrooper, just look. I can. That was Mount Everest. I'm on the way.
He's on the way.
Yeah, that was. But that's a great thing we've missed, I think, with this quarantine stuff is being able to have fun with your people.
That's it.
And get fits off and that kind of stuff. Do you have anybody else we haven't announced?
We do. We have two more names that we want to give away. So. From the raffle from this past week, we want to give okay, get the camera right, Gabe. All right. So earlier we announced Maria. You got them on your way. We'll take care of you. I have your information. We got you. The second one, at Ron the Don. We appreciate you, Ron the Don. You were one of the first people to fill out the raffle form. You were on it early. So we're going to take care of you. Size 9 on its way to you, my friend. Congratulations. We'll be in touch. Shout out to Ron the Don. Free pair of Vic Lloyd Adidas Forums on their way to you, my friend. Cheers. We'll be in touch soon. We got you.
Ron the Don. It's a fantastic name.
It's a great name.
I need to steal that name from him.
We got one left.
Yeah, what's the last one from the raffle?
Oh, we got hats.
We got a bunch of
who's
shit
in the chat right now? Atina don't want no hat. Let's see. All right, who's DP Soccer 930? DP Soccer, I don't know who you are, but if you DM us on the popup.com's Instagram,
they're right here.
We got winter wear from Crystal Head Vodka. Ron the Don, this is DP Soccer. DP Soccer 930, we're going to send you these in the mail. It's a Crystal Head beanie, we got you.
Daniel, I'm going to need a full, you know, post on Instagram.
Yeah, we need an unboxing.
We need everything. You now owe us. This is like more of like a death row kind of thing. So if we send you things, it also means that like we, you know, if you say have like a kid or something, we like have the right. That kind of like you owe us. Like you're like say like for instance, you had like a soul or something. Like we own that.
Yeah,
as
we
well.
Own it. Yeah.
The rights to that at least.
Hey, who else is in the chat? Let's see. Follow twice from Seattle. What size shoe do you wear? Put it in the chat. We could probably take care of you.
He has a big foot, I think.
Oh, maybe we might not get you finally. You know what I'm saying? Who else is in the chat right now that we can take care of for pulling up on us? Amanda Schwab, let us know what size you are. Let's see if we can take care of you right now. DP Soccer, we got you, DP.
This is love.
This is love, man. This is excellent. You know, and again, like we said, like not every show we're giving away like $130 shoes for free.
Right. But it could.
It could happen.
And.
Yeah, it could happen.
And as we evolve this thing, it's just like different cool little gems. We might have a guest. Mm-hmm. We might have this exclusive shit that if you're not here in this moment with us live.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I appreciate people that watch it afterwards.
Right.
Because it's going to be always game, things that we learn.
Right, right, right.
But it's a value in appointment watching this show. Mm-hmm. Also, before we forget, too, I wanted to ask you about things that you copped this week.
Okay. I copped this week.
To give them a chance to give our sizes and close out the show.
One thing I copped this week, I paid for my wife's Roth IRA. Shout out to Financial Freedom. Y'all, we're talking about shoes. I'm over here talking about wealth. You know what I'm saying?
That's the next step. That's the spinoff.
Great man.
That's the spinoff. Financial Freedom. What it was? Kev Ramsey.
Rich dad, poor dad. Yeah. That's funny as shit.
Actually, I spent X amount of $1,000 on a Roth IRA. So that's one thing I copped this week.
That's nice.
Let's see.
It's so nice that your friends are
we
washed.
We got you, Amanda. We got you.
Yeah, it's so nice when your friends are washed and like they're doing like, responsible shit. It's like, damn, this is cool.
All right.
Well, go ahead. I'm sorry.
No, so I paid the allotment for the Roth IRA. And then what the best thing that happened to me this week was I got like 40 items out of customs hold.
I saw, all right, y'all. I saw these items.
Yep. They're fire.
And Kev told me this, and I'm going to say it on whatever.
Let's do it.
These are items. This goes back to the like creating moments and creating unique things.
Yeah.
There are things in this box that you just genuinely can't get probably anywhere else. Maybe in the country, definitely not in Chicago. Just very unique.
We got imports, baby.
Pieces. And I was just proud of him to be able to see these pieces.
I was hyped.
The timely winter piece. Like, I'm not going to give too much of your stuff away.
Mm-hmm.
But there's genuine value in shopping.
Yeah.
And I think pulling up on the pop-up if you're in Chicago. Because there's dope shit that, like, sometimes you go to these places.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, whether it's a big box store or, you know, mom-and-pop resale shop. And it's like, okay, I don't know if I would really want to wear something that's in here.
Yeah.
But there's genuine stuff in here that even in that box, I was like, bro, these are some... I might not leave tonight without buying.
Right.
So, you know what I'm saying?
Listen, I appreciate you saying that. It's all about the curation. It's all about going and finding it. That's what I get a lot of joy out.
Right.
Like finding things.
Right.
I get more satisfaction of seeing things that walk out of the store that I've had to like hunt and scour for. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, that's part of the hustle is just like hunting. That's just what it is, you know?
a lot of my mom coming up. I know we're coming up on time, but my mom coming up, my mom fed us as a family for years off of reselling clothes.
Straight up.
Yeah, man. A lot of people don't know that. My mom literally, I mean, like wow. Her hustle back then, this is probably early 2000s, 2004, 2005, 2006, resold. There was a Banana Republic, and that's not like streetwear, but like Banana Republic, yeah. and like some Gap, that whole Old Navy Gap, mm-hmm. whatever, the whole shit, reselling that stuff from outlets on eBay back when eBay, 2001, yeah, 2000 eBay.
That was cracking.
So like I might not be, I've always said like the most prolific. I know everybody, every little thing, but like I've lived getting fed off of
hustling.
I'll get it for 30. I'm gonna sell it for 130.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So and I know how great that feeling is when somebody cops something.
Right.
Oh shit, I got this for, this price.
Absolutely.
You already know. So that it was cool for you to for me to witness you getting that stuff.
I appreciate that.
Because you're gonna feed your family off that shit too.
Yeah. I mean, I got two kids, you know what I'm saying? We out here. But look, just before we hop off, and we're right at time. What's up, Nick? Good to see you, man. Thanks for pulling up. We got a celebrity in the chat. Nick says go. Nick's blowing up. He's booming right now. We appreciate you, Nick. You doing your thing, G.
Next shout time out to you. Keep inspiring.
Yeah, we got. We need a Nick
sound
effect.
Get rid of the macaroni.
700% getting rid of the macaroni.
Hey, people.
But real talk. Before we close out the show, I just wanted to say, Social Builder, we got you. Send us a DM. We'll send you the shoes. We got you. J-Rayo, we got you. We'll take care of you. Send us a DM. We'll take care of you. And Amanda, we got you. We'll take care of you. We'll send you some shoes. We got you taken care of. The last winner from the raffle,
mm-hmm.
we picked three this past week for the raffle, is Nathan Thomo. So, Nathan, you were a 9.5. You enter the raffle. Congratulations. So, again, guys, we gave away six shoes for free.
This has
successful
been
for how much?
Free, dog. Free.
At the price of your firstborn. But that's in the terms and conditions. They'll just accept that.
Yeah. We got you. I'll take care of you. I'll take care of you.
This has been great, man. This has been a great episode. I enjoy doing this damn show.
It's awesome, man.
This brings me a lot of joy. I'm excited. I bought some stuff this past week, so I'm excited to wear that for the next episode.
Okay.
To drip or drown. I don't know what we're gonna do for the sale next, but regardless,
we'll figure something out. Y'all. Just
be
prepared.
Dripped up. Two Fridays from now. I feel like a lot of people. We got more people this episode than last. So for all y'all that have been engaged, tell a friend and tell a friend. Take a screenshot of us right now. Put
like
it on
and subscribe.
Like and subscribe.
We appreciate that. That helps us out. You know what I'm saying? It keeps the show going.
You know what I'm saying? And if the more that we can get sponsors and stuff, is the more that we can give back to y'all.
Yep.
And have a better reach and a reach in Chicago for creators. I'm a creative in Chicago, and Kev gave me a shot to pull up on y'all. So
actually, hold on. I didn't give him a shot. Danny volunteered his time to make the show more dynamic than it was last season. So we appreciate you, G.
Thank you, my boy. But that is the Pop-Up TV season 2, episode 2.
We'll see you next time.
Stay
appreciate
safe.
You. Peace.
Kitchen lights, cockroaches everywhere. Hit the kitchen lights, now it's marble floors everywhere. Call the carpenter, the roof on the coop's gone. Give a fuck what he sold, I'm the truth, homes. Kitchen fumed up, niggas jamming Tupac. Get my Benny Hondas on, working two pots. Baby need shoes, partner need bail money.
bloodhound for the bread. I just smell money. Niggas just right. I recollect. Hands on cheese and really counted them checks. I'm Donald Trump in a white tee and white ones. The conversation is money, nigga. You won't say. Seen them pies and talking so much white, it'll hurt your eyes. I really live in, man. Kind of so much paper, it'll hurt your hands. I'm what the streets made me, a product of my environment. Took what the streets gave me, product of my environment. Now it's 28 inches on a brand new Hummer. Tell you right now, it's gonna be a cold summer. Blew the brains out the Chevy, call it suicide. It's a way of life, that's how young niggas ride. Trap or die, gave them hope. They waiting on the sequel. It's clear to see the boy Jesus do it for the people. Seen them pies and talking so much white, it'll hurt your eyes. I really live in, man. Got so much paper, it'll hurt your hands.
Let's get it.
I'm the author of the book, yeah, genius wrote it. There's a message in my words, you gotta decode it. I seen it all, every gram, every bird. I spit the truth, every noun, every verse. I never exaggerated one line, one dime. Never lied to the people, not one time.
Never.
A hard head make a soft ass. And hard white will get you straight cash. Seen them pies and talking so much white, it'll hurt your eyes. I really live in, man. Got so much paper, it'll hurt your hands. Kitchen lights, cockroaches everywhere. Hit the kitchen lights, now it's marble floors everywhere. Call the carpenter, the roof on the coop's gone. Give a fuck what he sold, I'm the truth, homes. Kitchen fumed up, niggas jamming Tupac. Get my Benny Hunters on, working two pots. Baby need shoes, partner need bail money. Bloodhound for the bread, I just smell money. Niggas just right, I recollect. Hands on Jesus, really counted them checks. I'm Donald Trump in a white tee and white ones. The conversation is money, nigga, you won't say. Seen them pies and talking so much white, it'll hurt your eyes. I really live in, man. Got so much paper, it'll hurt your hands. I'm what the streets made me, a product of my environment. Took what the streets gave me, product of my environment. Now it's 28 inches on a brand new Hummer. Tell you right now, it's gonna be a cold summer. Blew the brains out the Chevy, call it suicide. It's a way of life, that's how young niggas ride. Trap or die, gave them hope. They waiting on the sequel. It's clear to see the boy Jesus do it for the people. Seen them pies and talking so much white, it'll hurt your eyes. I really live in, man. Got so much paper, it'll hurt your hands.
Let's get it.
I'm the author of the book, yeah, genius wrote it. There's a message in my words, you gotta decode it. I seen it all, every gram, every bird. I spit the truth, every noun, every verse. I
said one line, one dime. Never lied to the people, not one time.
Never.
A hard head make a soft ass. And hard white'll get you straight cash. It'll hurt your eyes. I really live it, man. Got it so much paper, it'll hurt your hands.